Hey guys, welcome to the Fluff and Tough show. And I'm Fluff, and obviously we've got my co-host Tough with us. Say hi, Tough.
Hello.
Oh, you're so cheery today. You can tell it's early. And we also have a very special friend. Hey friend, we have Velvet with us.
Hello.
Oh, it is early. In the UK, it's like 3 o'clock. Over in the States, it's like 7 or
Should
something.
I have like a tambourine on me, just like ringing bells, like, good morning.
You're on the Fluff and Tough show. You should be ecstatic.
Jumping
the
up
fireworks.
The pizzazz.
Exactly. I mean, Tough, you should
edit some spirit fingers.
I think Tough should edit in some like fireworks.
I could. I don't
Light
know.
Drops.
The tambourine idea sounds great. I'm just gonna randomly throw in tambourine jingles in the middle of the podcast.
I need to do it when
have it start
speak,
off like
so.
Quiet and then slowly grow into like loud, just like little jingles, and then just like jingle.
more cowbell.
So yeah, we have Velvet. She is 8 bits of Velvet. If you want to catch her on Twitter, she also has a YouTube channel. I have no idea what that is.
Velvet. It's the same. It's the same.
Oh my god.
It's the same thing. So there you go. But you can find all that information on her lovely little Twitter page. She writes guides for PST, and she also now is lovely and joined the imports. What?
Dun, da, da, da.
Insert
bum, bum, bum.
Fireworks.
Tambourine.
So she writes guides on both. She writes guides anywhere. You want her to write a guide, she will write it.
I just kind of throw myself out there, just like, if you want a guide, just let me know.
If you're an indie developer and you want a guide, hit this girl up. She will do you an amazing guide. Tough has known Velvet for a while, because Tough was on PST for a while, weren't you? So
a little bit.
You guys known
just
each other
a few
before.
Years, you know.
I don't know how long we've known each other. I've known of Velvet for a while, probably since she was
only,
around.
Yeah, we've only been like talking for maybe a year now, year and a half. So
yeah. Oh, really? Okay.
Sure, yeah, last year is when we like first started talking.
Maybe it just feels
outside
longer.
Of trophies. It does
feels,
feel longer.
Feels
sometimes
like
it's like that with Tough. Forever.
Hey.
I think you've been staff for like, was it a year now? Is it a year?
Yeah, I think I started, well, a little over a year. I started off in like March, April last year.
It feels so long. Oh, God.
Like decades.
It does.
Velvet was the like most awesome event director over on PST.
Oh, thanks, guys.
You were, yeah. I mean, I didn't participate, but I'm not a participating kind of person.
How dare you?
Just kidding.
I know. But yeah, I did, you know, there was loads of, a lot of our members, you know, they like what's the one where you
the
like,
THL
sweat yourself for a month?
THL.
Yeah, that's the one. That's the one. A lot of people like that. And don't sleep for about a month.
Yeah. Well, VNs are really good for that event because they're just so quick. You get those trophies so quick.
Well, the rat. How do you pronounce it?
Radalika.
Radalika.
That was good, Fluff. That was good.
Thanks. I've been practicing. Vel actually sent me a little, this is how you say their name. I was like, thanks.
Yeah. The LAI part always throws people off because
I can see you. Yeah, I can see Fluff in the mirror, like saying it over. Trying to get
no,
it right.
You can't see that. But I did send them a message and say, by the way, I missed your name up completely. And they just laughed. They found it funny. So, yeah, it was okay.
Yeah.
It was fine. But before we, like, go into what we've been playing, what we've been doing, about Bell's guides and stuff, Tough thought it was a clever idea not sure why she thought it was a clever idea, to get me to post, and I didn't think this through because she just bugs me for days and I just do it.
No pressure.
to get people to ask us questions. Oh dear Lord. So,
how many questions are there?
1, 2, 3, 4. One's a statement. 5, 6, 7. About 8 questions.
Good. God.
That many? I only saw like 4. I'm so unprepared.
Was one of them was on YouTube and one of them was on Facebook.
Okay.
So,
oh no.
We're going to start off with Top Dog RD4. Now, I think this must be directed to me. How blessed have you been to work with Rough Dog 4 over the past 8 or 9 years? Has it been that long? I feel old. How blessed have I been? I think I replied with the hand mailed towel emoji, and I think that about sums it up, doesn't it?
Yeah, what does that say? I don't know.
Blessed day. Blessed day. yeah. It's been eventful. it's had its moments. No, we're going all right. We sometimes have things that we need to talk about because we obviously co-own and run it together, and then we end up having like a 4-hour conference. I always say to him, "Be 5 minutes. Take 5 minutes." And it turns into like 4 hours because we end up just talking absolute nonsense. You know, like what's going on. You know, in my world, his world. Just general. So it ends up turning into a 4-hour conversation. We get on really well. But you know, we've both got our own ways of doing things, and I think that's what balances it out quite well. So yeah,
it's not all chaos.
It's not all chaos. And then Slammer's got 2 questions on here. At Slammer Jammer 28.
The slams.
The slam. So we got 2 questions. One is for Tuff. When did Tuff become at Tuff McMuff? My Twitter still wants to mention your other name. I am so confused. Aren't we all? We're all confused.
I did that on, Friday of last week? Because the Twitter was originally set up for poetry when I was doing like most of my writing and kind of in that world. And so my Twitter feed was a combination of poetry, politics, and gaming. And so I kind of just, I mean, I haven't been in the poetry world in probably 2 years now. So I decided I needed a more gamer-friendly handle. And so that's it. That's the story.
It was quite eventful, all the names that came out. Yeah. When you asked us.
Yeah, I don't even remember what all the suggestions were.
I remember quite a few.
The Real Tough Muff. Fluff's Bitch.
The Taco Mako.
Oh my God.
I think we should have done a poll. That would have been a better way of choosing it.
No, I think I would have ended up with some sort of ridiculous name like
420 tough.
It would have been like Tough 69420 tough 420 XX. No,
that sounds like a perfect name. You should have done a poll.
No, wah.
So then we have a question from, I'll come back to Slammer's other one. We have a question from Snatch 2497. Oh, good Lord. What are your
snatch? Does he say it snatch or does he say it snack? Does anybody know?
I'm not sure.
I think it's snatch. What are your thoughts on Brexit?
Oh my God.
God. And its ramifications on the wonderful island of islands. That's the first part. Well, my thoughts on Brexit, I don't have any. That sums out.
No thoughts. Move on.
I don't have any thoughts on that for this podcast. I think it's better that way. And then the gaming question, which I'm happy to answer. Gaming question, what's your most hated game you've ever played for trophies? Tough for sure, because I need to...
Oh, gosh. It's probably still... what's that Deer Simulator I played like a couple of Decembers ago? I played it for an event, and it was...
Cabrera's, isn't it?
No, it wasn't Cabela's. It was a different one.
There's more.
It's on the tip of my tongue. I know which one you're talking about.
I'm gonna have to look it up.
There's a W in there somewhere, like white.
White Tail Challenge.
Yes,
Something. I think it's White Tail Challenge. Let me look it up. Yeah, it is White Tail Challenge. That's a PlayStation 3 game, and it is one of the worst things you'll ever play. Like, I'd rather play back in 1995 25 times than play White Tail Challenge.
You're really hating on that game. Yeah. So much hate for 1995.
So yes. Yeah, that's my worst one for sure.
Velvet,
what about you, Velvet?
I couldn't decide between two of them. One is that stupid little Adventure on the Prairie game that everybody just absolutely loves. But it's short, so I kind of give it, it's like, whatever, we can just get it over with super quick. But my go-to absolutely hated game is Philippic's Adventure game. Just, it's too long, it's too tedious, it's boring, and I hate it. So,
fair enough. If you don't like it.
I haven't gone near those games yet because I kind of felt like that was going to be the case.
Yeah. It's one of the few that I'm like, I just want to get this over with. I want to delete it. I don't want to stack it. Just
be done. Just go away.
You don't want to ever, ever see it again.
No.
I'm trying to think of what... I wouldn't say hated, but... And this is going to be controversial. I really don't like the Lego game. I think boring.
I mean, I think that's a general. I think that's a. I don't think that's going to get a lot of hate. I think everyone agrees.
Yeah, but see, it took me 2 years. It took me 2 years to play Pirates of the Caribbean. 2 years, because I just found it so boring. I start playing it. I'm like, I want to go to bed. It makes me tired. It makes me physically tired playing them. It's not like I hate things. It's just, it wears me out.
They are pretty long.
I have like a love and hate for them. I think I enjoy them if I spread them out. But if I try to play too many all at once, then it's like the same thing over and over and over again.
It's just so boring. I'm just like, is it finished yet?
Like, no, you have to go collect a million bricks before you
can finish. I don't want to.
Yeah, you basically have to play the game twice, and you've got to pick up like every little bitty thing in the games I have that it's the Arkham Villains one to play.
Oh, I started Harry Potter. I ain't even bothered to finish it. I can't be bothered. I don't want to play it.
The Harry Potter ones are really long, but
they are. The one for Vita was fun.
Yeah, I wish I could play it again. Like, that's my favorite Lego game is Harry Potter. But just because I love the movie, so I'm just like, oh my god, I want to play this even more. But
I guess we won't judge you. No idea of fun.
Well, I haven't played any of the new ones because I know the new ones, they took like, this is a long game, and extended it by a couple of football fields, and I'm just. Nah, I'll wait until I need trophies.
No. I'm trying to think if there's any game that's really, really glitched on it. Because that, I would hate that. But it's like, there's so many games that just glitch on you, isn't there, that you have to restart over and over. But hate is a strong term, I think, for games. I don't really hate them. I mean, I just go back to them you know, and just carry on with it.
Just I think get it done.
Just, yeah, I think it's just a Lego that would just wind me up. I find it boring. And then we got another question from Slammer Jam 28.
Jam.
Do you like my little accent then? Slammer Jam.
I like it. I like it.
What are the origins of your PSN name? And then the second part is, what are your thoughts on the recent update to be able to change your PSN names? Any consideration for changing your own? Oh, God.
Who wants to take that one first?
I'm just wondering what Tufts answered. Quite a backstory.
I'm trying to think whether to give my member of the month answer or the true answer. Fine.
You go first, Fluff.
Basically, my nickname was Fluff Girl. But obviously, I was not going to choose that as a PSN ID, was I? That was going to be no. So do I need to explain how I got Fluff Girl? I don't think I do. Do I? Nah. Do I?
Do I? It's up to you.
Okay, so when I was when I was 16, I was what was called a YTS, which is a part of a youth training scheme. So you work 4 days a week in a job, and then 1 day a week at college. So there was a few of us, and I worked in the IT department, and it was obviously all guys, and my friend, she worked in the shipping department, and we used to make up little nicknames for the guys, and it used to irritate the fuck out of them. It really wound them up. So they came up with the Fluff Girls for me and my friend, and we had no clue what that meant, none whatsoever, and we were just like, yeah, whatever. But it stuck. It just stuck. Even my friend started calling me Fluff. It never stuck with her. Stuck with just with me, Fluff Girl. and even my family like calling me Fluffy and Fluff. And my dad said to me one day, "Do you know what a Fluff Girl is?"
Oh God.
I was like, no. Because obviously later on down the line, I found out what that meant. I mean, we used to go clubbing with these guys and everything, so really they had the last laugh on us. Well, me. So that's how the fluff girl part came about. And then when I got my PS3 and you could choose your name, I was like, oh God, I can't put Fluff Girl in it. Can you imagine having Fluff Girl? And I'd had a Nintendo Wii. I used to play, you know, Raving Rabbids quite a bit. So I thought, oh, I'll just have the rabbit bit, so Fluffy Rabbit. That's how that came about. Oh, jeez. Anyway.
Like
next.
It.
Next.
You want to go, V?
Sure. I mean, mine's just a stupid story, so it's it's not nearly as involved as Fluffy's.
That's okay.
Yeah, so my PSN is Blood Velvet, for those who don't. No. And before I made my ID, I was using a friend's old account to play. And then he was like, you need to make your own. I was like, okay, fine. And then I was trying to figure out a name. And at the time, this is so stupid. I'm sorry. we had a bunch of remote control helicopters that we would play around with because we were just dorks and whatever. And I got hit in the face with one and it ended up giving me a bloody nose. And my friend was saying how the blood looked like velvet was like running down my face, and I was like, that doesn't even make sense. And then it just kind of stuck on me, just like blood velvet. So that's how that name came along, is because I got hit in the face with a remote control helicopter.
That's a great story.
That's a stupid story.
I like it.
I got my PSN ID from being smacked in the face.
You ever get a nosebleed? That's what it came from.
Yes. Okay, so mine's not as exciting as I think you guys think it is, and you'll probably heard this story, but I, when I got my PS3, I was Oh God, I was in my, I don't know how old I was. When was that? When did the PS3 come out?
Well, you're older than me, so.
Like originally.
Like 2007, 2008-ish, maybe.
Yeah, seven. Yeah. So I was in my like mid-20s and had a guy roommate, and we always had friends over. And so when I was setting it up, I didn't know anything about like online gaming. I never did online gaming. So like the PS3 was my first delve into anything online. And so, you know, it comes up, you have to pick a name. And I was like, I have no idea. And this is what you get for choosing a name with boys around. And they were like, you should put Tough Muff. You should put Tough Muff. That would be great. And I was like, I didn't think anything of it because, number one, there weren't trophies at the time. I wasn't interested in going online. So it was just something that was going to be for me, right? Right. So that's what I went with. And then, I don't know, I just never thought about it until I was playing Warhawk one time and this little kid was on there and he was like, hey, Tough Muff. Let's group up, Tough Muff. Join my game, Tough Muff. And I was like, oh my God, please stop saying that. All I could think about was this kid's parents were going to hear him saying, hey, Tough Muff, come here. And then I was going to end up in trouble. I have thought about changing it, but I'm afraid, because I do play so much online now, I'm afraid it'll mess up my online progress in games. So I'm sticking with it for now.
Yeah, I'm not bothered by changing it. What's the point? What for?
And I think at this point, and this goes into, like, I guess, a deeper conversation, but it's, like, part of my identity now. I'm not sure what I would do if I changed it. Who would I be if I changed it?
Mine's not as deep as that. Mine's just like, why? What's the point?
Like, after you've gone by a name for, like, 7, 8, 9, 10 years, it's like, well, if I change it, then it's like, is that really me? Like, no. Yeah.
Who am I anymore? Yeah.
The only thing I guess I would change, it's a rabbit bit, but what for? You know, it's like, because you originally chose it, didn't you? You chose it. You've had it for so long. I just don't see the point, really.
Yeah.
But that's just me.
But some people enjoy it. Like, I know Pricey has changed his name. Has he done it twice already or just once? I can't remember.
I don't know. He changes his name constantly.
Yeah, he does change his name a lot.
Oh, on Discord, yeah.
Maybe it's a young thing.
So. I was about to say, maybe it's like people who haven't had their accounts for like super long, because figure his account's only like a year old, so it wasn't as much of a like an issue, I guess. And then you have people like Dan who have just super long names. Yeah, like, please change this.
Yeah. I mean, I could see if I had a bunch of numbers on mine, or if I had made mine, so it was, I don't know, I could see changing it then, but I don't know. I'm not in any rush. I wish that Tuffins was available, but it's not.
See, I'd have to change. Yeah. No. I was thinking, would I change it to Fluff Girl? No, I wouldn't. No, I wouldn't. So
that name might not be available anymore.
I doubt it is. I honestly doubt it is.
I mean, I could see like Velvet changing hers to 8 Bits of Velvet. Just
but you can't you can't start your name with a number. That's the only reason.
That's dumb.
Yeah. So it kind of kills me. Like, I'm a little bummed. Just really, come on, Sony. Like,
yes, Sony. This is like a petition. Sort your shit out.
I'm trying to be like cohesive across all platforms, and y'all are just ruining it. So,
God damn. You'd think with this introduction of it, they would open it up to allow more options on the PlayStation.
Messing with Velvet's groove.
Right. But it's okay. I don't know if I would change it. So
you would.
I would consider it heavily, but I don't know if I would actually.
And after a couple of wines.
Wake up the next morning, just like, where's my name?
What happened?
So drunk, I'd probably spell it wrong.
That's something that I would do. I could see myself changing my name in the evenings when I've had a little too much of everything. And I wake up and it's like, I don't know. God only knows what it would be.
Yeah.
That would be so funny, though. We could just do a poll. What should Tuff's name be? She's so drunk, she won't care. Wakes up in the morning.
Whatever.
You would, though. I wouldn't. You would.
Oh, my God.
I would love to have, like, the lady, like, videotaping you when you, like, go onto your PlayStation after doing that and just being like, what is happening right now?
Do a little recording of when she's doing it and then the wake, the aftermath of the wake up with this, just like, what? Oh, what is this?
Be horrible.
Ah, but it'd be funny. So then the next question, and I mean, this is more of a statement, really. And this is from the Blake Vulture.
Oh, gosh.
He put, I know a very special person who would be a perfect guest on the Fluff and Tuff show. I didn't know if he knew Keanu Reeves, but we are really open to that. I mean, we all want that, right?
Absolutely, absolutely. He must have been reading our minds, right?
Exactly. I mean, if Keanu wants to come on here and talk about cyber, I'm all for it.
Talk about the Matrix. Really?
You can talk about the Matrix. You can talk about anything. And I'm sure Velvet will come back on for that edition. Am I right?
He could talk about his hair care treatment, and I'd still be like, all right, sure. Like,
yeah, you can talk about your hair, your beard, whatever you want. We'll be happy to have you. So, Blake, you know, you want to reach out to Keanu, we're all about that. Because otherwise, I'm not really sure who he's talking about there. But anyway.
I just realized I've been saying his name wrong this entire time. I thought it was Black Vulture. Is it really Blake Vulture?
Well, I don't know. Maybe I'm saying it wrong.
I thought it was Black. Sorry, also, Fluffy just makes up how to say things. I mean,
she's got two K's.
Like, is that what's happening right now?
He's got two K's.
But the bird in his thing is black, right?
Well, he's got two K's.
Well, let's not talk about his spelling, okay?
Oh, like, he's gonna have a lot of questions when he hears this. Just like, really?
Well, you're probably going, it's Fluffy.
Gonna watch the intro to his video really quick because I know he says it. Like,
does he? Oh, God. Did I miss that part?
I'm pretty sure he says black.
Does he? I thought he said the Blake Vulture.
Maybe he does. I don't know.
I'm going. I'm checking. We're going.
Do it. You check it. Yeah, you should play it.
No.
No.
I'm pretty sure he says it's the Blake Vulture.
I think it's great. I think I'm going to so look forward to the way that Fluff says everyone's name from now on.
Black Vulture.
Does it?
Yeah.
Maybe I'll hear it wrong.
I'm going to call him Blake now, Blake Vulture. Say Blake.
Maybe I'll hear it wrong. Oh, well. Anyway. But now we've taken 5 minutes to clear that up. As an added bonus, you got one more view on a video.
Oh, see, there you go. Well, I already viewed this one, but
you're welcome.
You're welcome. Moving on. Este, I'm not sure if I can read this. I mean, I'm not going to answer this question, Este, so, you know.
What did she ask? I didn't even see this.
Thanks for the input. Still not going to answer it. She put, I can't ask questions on other social media platforms. Get Twitter. How many times do I have to tell you, get Twitter? So I'll ask it here. And then she's put brass eyes, LOL. That's Esty.
She put what?
She's put, I can't ask a question on other social media. So I'll ask here, brass eyes, LOL.
Brass eyes?
Brass eyes.
Brass
eyes. Oh, brass eyes. Yeah. I was hearing it the same as Tuff. Like, I was legit about to type in brass eyes. Like, is there emoji for brass eyes?
See, maybe I'm saying things right all along. And he's
Okay, bra size. Yeah, I'm gonna plead the fifth there. I don't think anyone needs to know that.
Yeah, that's No, we're good.
Thanks for your input, SD.
My bra size is well endowed. How about that?
And I'm sure Iva is very happy for that. But she left that on YouTube, so yeah, thanks. And then Tyson on Facebook has put, who is hashtag fluff and tough as a person? How long have they been doing this hobby for? What draws them into the hobby at first? And what is the gaming goal of the year?
That's a big question.
I'm not a person.
No, we're robots.
We're robots. Sent to destroy the Earth by Rough Dog 4.
Revelations. Tambourine.
Mic drop. What draws us into this hobby? Are you saying the podcast is a hobby?
Does it mean the podcast or trophies?
I've had a lot better hobbies than this.
Yeah, I don't know. Fluff twisted my fingers for this.
What? Whoa.
Excuse me?
Hold up, because I had about 20 messages to get here on time for 3 o'clock. You're like, are you coming? Are you going to do it? Are you going to be here?
Do I sound like that?
Yeah, that's my impression of you.
Fuck off!
There's a better impression that you did of yourself last week.
Oh. Shut up.
Have games.
Have games, we'll play.
Have games, we'll play. Velvet?
Yeah, sure.
What an awesome question, thank you.
I can elaborate a little bit on the goals.
Oh, you don't want to hear. Yeah, you want to be in the top 1 million of the world. Yeah. Was that what you were going to say?
I hate you. When we're done with the podcast, I'm going to fly to the UK.
Okay.
And toilet paper your house.
No, you're not. I'll have you arrested.
I'll have you arrested.
See how you like them apples.
I can see like me toilet papering the house and Fluff just like with a cup of tea looking out the window being like, all right, bitch. And then here comes the police.
Exactly. I'll be like, there she is. And then down you go. And then
they're gonna shoot me? I thought they only did that here in the US.
Yeah, but I would have told them.
Oh, she's known over in the States.
All right, moving on. Well, the last question we had was from Zenovark. How do you pronounce that?
Zenovka.
Yes, how do you handle your massive fame? Well, tough is a nightmare with this fame. Oh my days, absolute nightmare. She's gone all prima donna and everything. It's such a hassle. All the demands. She wants more money, wants more pay, wants better conditions.
More nude photos.
Oh, Phil, that's a bit extreme, isn't it? Phil don't even know about that.
Yeah, when you're a guest, you have to.
Well, now I do.
I don't think she's signed that contract.
We got the ones in from Nitro, and I use them to scare the roaches away in the house.
Oh, that's mean. Or Nitro.
Love
you.
Whichever
you want to pronounce his name. We're not sure.
Is that all the questions?
That's it.
Whew, thank goodness. That was exhausting.
Yeah, I know. You've got to pick a winner. Yeah, we'll do that on the Twitter, though, because, you know, there's hassle.
Yeah.
So, let's talk a little bit about Velvet.
Dun, 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 dun.
Dun, dun, dun. So, Velvet is a guide writer, supreme. She's written a lot of guides. yeah, you are. You don't get enough goddamn credit. That's what I think.
Truth.
Truth, innit? So, what's your favorite guide? What you've been doing? What's occurring?
Favorite guide out of, like, all of them?
Millions.
Yes. Millions. I don't know. I really liked writing the Sir Eats a Lot guide. Like, that's still kind of my go-to as far as, like, fun to just do.
And the developer was really happy with that guide because they
behind the stone. Yeah.
They did a lot of retweeting and they sent you a little gift, didn't they?
They did, yes. Which was pretty cool. But yeah, no, they're super sweet. They're really sweet. So definitely like them.
I thought it was really nice that they gave you massive props for that. So
it's a cute game. I need to finish it. I have not finished it. I know, don't kill me.
Yeah, I have to go. It's better if you finish it now because they the last update of the game added the last update of the game added the map system. So you're not playing as blind and you can just utilize that.
Well, that's cool. I think I was about a third of the way finished, and then I don't know. I got busy on other things, but the guide was perfect so far.
Thank you.
How many guides have you done? Like, I know even before the YouTube, you've done.
Well, I don't know if you can include the two going up today. With those, yeah, 91. I'm at 91.
Nice.
That's a lot.
I'm getting there. I want to hit 100, but I don't want to rush it. I just want to hit it.
Well, I think the difference is that you put a lot of detail in yours, and you also do like a really nice text guide with that, and you give the option of a video guide as well.
Yeah,
which I think makes it nice because I sometimes just use both.
Yeah, I like covering all bases, just because I know sometimes I'll be at work on my Vita and I can't just watch a video, so I have to use a text guide. And I know some people don't like pausing, playing. And then some people don't like reading walls of text. So it's like, okay, you know what? Fine. All y'all are going to get what you want out of this. So.
All you needy bitches.
Yeah, it's like, you don't want that? Fine, have this. You don't want that? Fine, have this. But I like doing them, so I really don't mind. That's okay.
And you try and work closely with the developer as well and make sure that they like what you're doing.
I try to, yeah. I feel like I annoy them sometimes, but not in like a bad way, I hope. Like, I won't post a guide, at least nowadays, I won't post it without them kind of, like, approving it. Just, like, did I mess up anything? Are we good? And I know Tuff is playing the Savior's Gang right now, which is, like, the big one where it's, like, I've been talking to them every day for almost 2 weeks, getting patches and bugs fixed. And I really like that stuff. So it's not so much.
I think that's awesome. Because I don't think they would have even known. I don't know that they would have been on it as fast if you hadn't been corresponding with them.
Yeah, like Fluffy and I talk about that sometimes. Just like, you know, if you're going to write a guide and there's like a problem with it, then like you can say something. Like you are allowed to say something, but just don't be a dick about it. Don't be like, this is broken. This is a piece of shit.
Your game sucks. The trophies don't pop.
Yeah, just like, what is, I paid money for this, how dare you? Just like, if you just message them like, hey, just letting you know, I am a trophy hunter, this is like what I do and it's not working, do you know about this, are you fixing this, and all that stuff. And for the most part, they're really responsive. Like, there's only been one or two that are like, they just don't respond, so
They're like,
I guess I'm not getting this fixed. Like, all right, that's cool.
We had that recently with Bombfest.
Zach. Yeah.
Because you wrote a guide for Bombfest. We wrote at White Fawn Games, because they're the publisher, about the, was it Natty's 20?
The Natty 20s, yeah.
To help get that fix, which they've, you know, they put out the patch, and I believe that's resolved now. So
it is, yeah,
that's awesome.
Yeah, so.
But I mean, not enough people. I don't think enough people have played that game because it looks really fun.
It is really fun. Like, I wish it had online, and I know he's, you know,
it's coming.
Playing around with it. Yeah, he's definitely playing around with it right now. And but even local, it was a lot of fun. I definitely recommend it for party games.
I think the DLC drops for Steam on July 15th. So I think after that, it will come for the
console. Yeah,
I know it's definitely coming. But Whitethorn published some really cool games. I know that me and you, I don't know if Tufts has put in for it, but kickstarted Evan's Remains.
The Calico Girl.
Yeah, we did the Calico as well, which is a cat cafe game. But they have some really interesting games coming up. So they're more chilled, aren't they? More chilled out.
They are, yeah.
They also did Where the Bees Make Honey, which is another chilled out game. But
I really liked that game. I know people got all riled up about the rabbit part, but I enjoyed that game. Thought it was cute.
Well, that's got fixed now.
yes, it's been fixed.
Oh, is it?
I need to get y'all on. Please don't touch anything. I need to sick y'all on those devs because that game has been broken since it came out, and they no respond to me.
Oh, okay.
And I did a guide where I haven't finished it because I got frustrated that it's broken, but yeah. It's like 80% done and no platinum because I think it's two trophies that just will not pop, and they're easy trophies, so there's no reason why they shouldn't. It's just broken.
Yeah.
Oh well. Yeah. Normally, if you write the developer or publisher, they will reach out. It might be a different publisher. Might be different for to the developer.
Yeah, I think there was two. I found like whoever, and I always get confused about that. I guess the publishers who puts the game onto Sony or onto the PlayStation. So I'm a little dumb in that way. But I messaged both, but no response. So
if you send it to me afterwards, yeah. I'll send them a message.
Yes,
me and like
get my gang of women on them.
Yeah. Like, look, I'm trying to get this done. We're trying to promote your game, yo, but I can't promote a broken game. So
yeah.
I mean, I can't talk to them.
And it's fun. And it would be, I mean, the game is fun itself, and it would be great, great for the trophy whores if they would fix it, because it's pretty easy too.
Nice. So what other guides have you been doing? Because I noticed you did the Effie.
That was a cute one. That was really, really hyped on Twitter, but I don't know if I'm like in the boat of agreeing that it deserved that much hype, and I kind of feel bad saying that, but it was all right. It wasn't the greatest thing since sliced bread, but
I watched a little clip of the game, and I noticed like, see, it reminded me of some other sort of styles of games. But so when you're doing stuff within the game, you get like a story narrated throughout the game.
Yes, he kind of like, you play as Galland, and he doesn't actually like talk in the game. He more speaks in third person, like he's telling a story to Effie, this little girl. So he's playing as if he's reading that story to her or telling her that story. So if you die and you come back, he'll be like, "That's not what happened. Galen was just distracted."
That's just what
like
I noticed.
Third person like that. And it's like, all right. But he is telling a story.
Yeah, I watched up to the point where he's going to get the fountain, going to the Fountain of Youth, and they, you know, he's inside there and collecting, going to the chests, and they give him a shield. You know, it was quite early on in the game, but I just sort of wanted to see what the game was about.
Yeah, I mean, it's a good game. It's just, it's really, just really popular right now, but yeah,
but it must be well made.
Yeah, well, it's well made. It's definitely, like, there's no bugs. There's nothing that I was like, oh, this hitbox is the worst or this platforming is the worst. Like, it's all very, very well made.
Well, I think they did a really good job of marketing the game, too.
They did,
awesome. Yes. The PR, it was everywhere. I mean, it was all over my social media.
Yeah, and it's a student-made game, which really helped sell it. Like, not just some independent studio. Like, they were all students.
That's pretty cool. I didn't know that.
I didn't know that either.
But
you did Super Skellamania.
Super Skellamania.
Oh, so cute. I need to play
it. Oh, man. Tough. You'll like it. I think you'll really like it. I felt so stupid about the speed run, though.
Like, why?
I did not realize there was an autosave feature, and I was legit trying to get that 17
oh,
minutes.
Shit.
Oh, my God. I probably spent a good, I would say, 8-9 hours trying to get that 17-minute run perfectly before realizing that there was an autosave feature, and I had to put the game down. I was just like, I hate myself so much right now. Like, I've wasted so much time, but but it was
that
fun.
Sounds like something that I would do. So basically that you can kind of save scum it,
kind of. Yeah, so again, each time you go through a door, it auto saves, so you can practice the next section and get it perfect, and then just quit to the main menu, hit continue, and then play that section and just keep doing that over and over again.
Nice.
Yeah. It helps a lot.
Yeah.
17 minutes doesn't sound like a lot, like a long time, but if you're doing it all in one go, you have to get it like absolutely perfect to meet that time. And
yeah.
Well, don't you feel like super accomplished having done that?
Yes, actually. Like, not even beating around the bush. Like, you know what? It's fucking done.
And her thumbs hurt like hell.
Oh, yes, they were swollen the next day. So.
Oh, that's the worst.
Oh, man. Nice. So, have you been playing anything else this week that you're prepared to talk about? Because obviously you're writing guides and stuff. So.
Yeah, keep in mind, this won't be published for like a couple of few days. So,
it's fine.
Will be out before this episode is. So.
Well, the one right now, we still have one trophy in Savior's Gang that is broken. So the videos are getting done for at least the S ranks right now, which this game is just so stupidly fun. Like, I don't know. It's just silly. It's sarcastic and silly. And I wish
I've enjoyed it. The only reason I stopped playing because I knew you were working on a guide and I just kind of wanted to wait and kill two birds with one stone. But
for sure.
The five levels that I did were a lot of fun.
Yeah, no, it's definitely, I love that you play as definitely not Jesus. Every time, just like, who's the main character? It's definitely not Jesus. and then the other one is that, I don't know how to pronounce it yet, because I haven't heard anybody say it, Ovivo, the new game.
Ovivo.
Ovivo.
Yeah, one of those. That's the other one.
That's sometimes you.
Sometimes you, yeah. And yeah. It's hard, I think.
Oh, okay.
No, that's the name of the developer.
Oh, right.
I thought you said
it. I was like, okay.
Okay, cool.
I think it's unusual.
No, like their name is like is hard, like IZ and then space hard, like is
interesting,
hard,
so. Is hard.
Yeah, I was like, wait, that sounded like it's not hard. Just
then I was thinking in my head, well, Crash Bot. People are saying Crash Bot's hard, and maybe it is hard.
Yeah.
Oh my goodness. So what is it like?
It's a puzzle platformer. You play in a black and white world, and
I like that look though.
It's very very easy on the eye. But you go through these massive pictures and you just hit X to switch between the black and the white area. And black, you roll on top, white, you roll on the bottom. So you have to like flip between each section to forward. I don't know if that makes sense.
Yeah, it does.
But it's kind of short. I'm a little bummed that it was so short, but
oh, okay.
It's pretty good. So I definitely recommend it.
Is it just PS4 or?
No, it actually came out on Android a while ago and was ported to the PS4. And I think it's also either out or coming out on Switch.
Is it going to be on the Vita?
No, no Vita.
Vita. Well, then, I mean, some people are starting to move away from.
I know.
It's sad.
We are finding it more than more nowadays.
Yeah.
And anything else you've been playing or?
Just the Contra anniversary outside of that, but that's just a play. Oh, just yes. A play.
Me too.
I love that game.
I haven't earned any trophies because I kind of suck, but I've been playing it pretty crazily.
I thought you meant like just in general, you haven't earned any trophies. What?
Oh no. I just meant in that game.
Who are you?
You basically have to beat each of the games and you can save Skummet also, but I've been trying to just go through and beat them in one go, and I haven't had any luck yet.
Yeah. I remember I used to play that game all the time with my brother back when we were like itty-bitty, and he was streaming when I was playing it when it first came out, and I beat the first boss, and I was just like, for the first time in my life, I beat the first boss of Contra without you.
That's awesome.
He was just like, I want to play it. And I was like, then get it. It's really fun. It's a good throwback. So.
Nice. So what has Tuffins been playing? Here comes the list. Blah, 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 blah.
All right, you shit.
Well, we know it's going to be a long list.
It's just a little bit of a long list. Actually, I haven't played as much this week as I usually do, so it's not as long as it could be. How about
that?
Were you ill? No. I've been stuck on Fallout still.
Okay.
But, let's see. So I have been playing some of the Contra collection also. I played, trying to think. I did try Home Sweet Home for 5 minutes. And then I turned it off because fuck that.
Why? Why did you turn it off in five minutes? I mean, that's a cutscene, the first 5 minutes. So what?
That's all it takes.
Maybe it was longer than 5 minutes. I don't know. The first time that I had to run away from that creepy lady.
Oh, she's not creepy. She just wants to tell you a little story.
Mm-hmm. Whatever. I played another stack of Sun. Got that done in quick time, thanks to someone named Velvet's Guide.
Yay! I still like that game.
That's where Timbering will come in right there. So I think my favorite game this week was Luna. Oh, Luna is so
good. Yeah, I played that as well.
Gorgeous game. Super. I mean, it's easy. There's nothing remotely difficult.
And who's that boy?
Oh gosh, what's their name? You're gonna get me to lie because I don't
know. Because if you pronounce it, that means I don't have to.
Oh, I see what's happening. I see what you're doing. I'll have to look it up. But yeah, it's like the art in it is just gorgeous. I have a thing for red birds, so that I didn't even know the game was coming out.
What kind of a thing? I've got a thing for red birds.
Well, they're beautiful. You shut your mouth. Duh. You see what I have to deal with, Velvet? I don't even know.
An animal in it, you can grant it that Tuff's going to play it.
There you go. Thank you. It looks like Funomina. Funomina is the studio. F-U Funomina.
See? It's not fun, is it?
It isn't.
Phenomena.
Phenomena. Oh, phenomena. Phenomena.
Phenomena. See, look, we can put it.
I hope that's right. I really hope that's right. That
we can do a little fake tune for them and everything.
I know. If it's not that, we're going to have to message them and say, hey, like, I get that you wanted it to be Funomina, but we've named it Phenomena. But yeah, I mean, it's a precious little game. It's a great trophy game because you'll have the trophies within an hour. So that one was my favorite. I like little quiet, sweet, end well games like that. I played Tarot Readings Premium, which was just crap. That was just trophy spam. And, oh, this is the kicker right here, ladies. Last night, I started Leisure Suite Larry. Wet dreams don't dry.
Oh.
And it is as cringeworthy and raunchy and ridiculous as you would imagine it to be. Now, that being said, it did have me laughing at a few different parts, and the gameplay isn't terrible. So,
were you drunk? Yeah,
that's a relative term.
I was feeling pretty good. So I'll pick that up again today and see if I don't hate the latter half of it, but not bad. Following a guide by Miss Mindy.
Mind is a city.
Yes. And so her guides are great, so that has gone well. Yeah, that's what I've played. And then of course Fallout. It's double XP weekend, so I'm trying to inch my way to level 100 so I can finally get my platinum. I think I'm at 82. Oh, 18 more levels.
So close.
Away. I think I'm at like 200 hours, 300 hours, something ridiculous. Ooh. In that game. Yeah, that level 100 is a grind.
It'll be worth it though.
Like, yes.
I would imagine it's still, is it ultra rare? Very
rare? It's an ultra rare. I don't think it's like super ultra rare, but it's an ultra rare. It's not like I think it's like 4% or something like
that. Oh, close. Yeah.
Yeah. So, yeah. So that's me. What you got, Fluff?
Well, I was away, so I haven't played much because I did go away. It was my birthday.
Happy birthday.
Thanks.
I don't even know.
Me now.
No, I don't tell people I'm going away because, you know, why would you tell people you're going away and your house is empty? That seems dumb.
Well,
that's when people can steal things, Fluff.
I might, but I don't think anyone else would. Just like
you knew I was away,
taking your stuff. I know, and I plotted. I tried to see if I could get a plane ticket, so I could go and do inappropriate things in your house while you were gone. But didn't happen.
See, I'm not of the generation where you like announce everything on social media. But, yeah, it's just not my thing. I think what it is I saw a Facebook thing about this bird who. You know, in that local group, you can be in these local groups on Facebook and stuff. You know, in local groups? About this bird who used to announce her whole entire life on these, whatever, social media and that. And she went to get her hair cut and she announced all that and was live whatever in it. And while she was live her hair cutting, someone went round her house and robbed it.
Oh, God.
I mean, it's terrible. I don't know why I'm laughing. But however, the police said to her, it's because you're live streaming everything and people can say where you live. Because, you know, she'd filmed where she lived on there.
Yeah.
That's a bit much.
Yeah, but like, you know, you say you're out and that, people, unfortunately, it's the world you live in today, isn't it?
Yeah.
Sad, but true. So anyway, yeah, I was away, had a very nice time, went to the coast, it was lovely. And now I'm not at the coast, I'm home. I haven't played much, but I did play Luna, which was very nice. It's like a little interactive story. So, and the guy, Dino Roar, did a guide, didn't he?
Yes.
That's his Twitter handle, anyway.
Dino Roar. I used to call him Dino, and then I realized that he was playing on dinosaur, like Dino Roar. And I was like, oh my God.
He done a text guide, and he has got a YouTube video of him playing the game as well. If you want to check out and see what it looks like, we do have his video on the Twitter page. And I also played Remothered Torch, was it Tormented Fathers?
Oh boy.
What?
It's scary. I watched the guide. I can't play that game.
That name alone is very intimidating.
The guy, oh gosh, watch the video play.
It's did you see my picture yesterday?
Yes, I did. You were hiding under a bed.
I was hiding under a sofa while this guy was walking around. Guy's walking around in an apron, nothing else on. He's got like this, what can only be classed as a Dothraki sword. You know, they're like that hook sword thing that they have. Stalking me. He's like looking for me. He wouldn't go away from me. Man, can't get out of here. But yeah, it's it's very stalkerish, and there are parts in it where you're like, what the hell is going on in this house? I've had a couple of crashes in the game, which was a little bit disappointing, but I think maybe it's just, you know, my system, whatever. Can be your system, can't it? Because Estee didn't report any issues with hers. It's very sneaky. Right at the end, Tuff was messaging me like, come on. I'm like, for God's sake, right at the end, woman. I've had to get off the game. I was like, for God's sake, can't even complete a game. Oh. So I'm like,
rude.
So I'm not saying rude right at the end of this. I nearly finished it. I'm going through the attic where a woman's trying to stab me with a what can only be described as a sword. But I don't know what it is, but she's trying to stab me up. You're like, come on, get off your game. Your enjoyment time's over. You've got to come do this. Unbelievable.
Somebody's got to keep you on track.
Really?
Yeah.
I'm all right keeping track, thank you very much. Anyway, guide is by Estee. And yeah, they're at Remothered Game. Follow them if you want to have a check out. I think more people should play this. Not a lot of people have. It's I'm gonna say it's about 2 hours. It's
not too bad.
Yeah, I'm gonna say about 2-3 hours. Because you will die. There's no doubt about it. You're gonna get stabbed. They're going to catch her. It's a bit like that other game where we were getting stalked. What was that? The
Caretaker?
Yeah. No.
No, which one?
Last week.
Intruders.
Intruders, yeah. You're going to get caught. You're going to get stabbed. So just save loads in the mirrors. You save in the mirror, which I quite like that little, you know, saving in the mirror thing. Just save loads. And then, you know, you restart from the save point. Go and get any collectibles that, you know, since she died.
Well, she did a text guide, so maybe I'll try it. Because I hate watching, I don't know.
Yeah, what I've done is I've basically followed the text for the collectibles and just wandered around aimlessly. And then when it's come to this ending scene or the scene where you're getting chased by Jennifer, not Jennifer, I don't know, it's a bit of the story, I don't want to ruin it. I followed that because, you know, it's an insta death. So just followed that of where to go. But I think it's pretty much straightforward, to be honest. But for the collectibles, yeah, I followed. So, and if you're missing any collectibles, before you go in the attic with the lovely Gloria, just wander around the house. You can pick them all up.
I don't have anything to do with Gloria or Jennifer.
Well, then don't play the game because you're going to have to.
No, I'm not going to.
But are you going to play it?
Evil bitches.
Well, they're not. They're just misunderstood.
Misunderstood and they're just trying to kill you. No biggie. Like,
no big deal.
I don't mean it.
They're misunderstood murderers.
Yeah, you could look at this the other way. You come into their house, uninvited, you're ruining through their stuff. I mean,
they're just protecting themselves.
No one ever thinks about that, do they? They never think about how we're just, you know, these people in these horror movies are just invading bad people's space. They deserve to die.
Yeah. You've come into their ass, looking through their drawers. What do you expect to happen? It's a cleaver straight through the head. That's what's happening there.
Gosh.
But yeah, it's a good game. And what I pre-ordered yesterday was The Sinking City. Looks really good.
Oh, yeah.
I get it 2 days early because I pre-ordered it.
Oh, nice. Nice.
I thought, though, because I misread it, because I went into the, I don't know, special edition. I can't remember what that's called. And it said 25th. I was like, ooh, so that means I'll get it on the 23rd. Exciting. And then I was like, clicked on it to download it. I was thinking, well, I should be able to play that today. And then it was like, no, you can't play that for another 2 days.
You're like, what?
Denied.
Oh.
So then I went into the original, like the normal version, and it says out 27th. I was like, God damn it.
So the 25th is 2 days early.
Yeah. I was like, ah. So. But I'm looking forward to it. It looks good. I like it. I like the look of it.
Those look fun. What's next on the guide front, Velvet?
1980X is next. It got delayed a week. I'm kind of bummed.
What is 1980X?
It is a Kickstarter project.
Ooh.
Yeah, I don't know the name of the developers, and I feel really bad about that because I feel like I've been following them. I'm like, I can't think of their name right now. So sorry. But it's a 5-in-1 arcade game.
Ooh.
That's supposed to be like a throwback to like 80s. It's like 80s arcade games, but with nowadays really smooth pixel graphics and soundtrack. But
is it High Bit Studio?
Yes, them. Yes. High Bit Studio. How do I not remember that? But
I can never remember those adult developers' names. That sounds cool. Yeah. I haven't even heard of that. I'm excited about that.
Yeah. No, I've been trying to keep it, like, I've been trying not to say anything, like, you guys know why. So, it was supposed to come out last week, and I was like, okay, this is it. And then they were like, it's out, but the PS4 is delayed a week. And I was like, damn it.
So this is going to drop on Tuesday?
Yeah, so it'll be coming out.
Nice.
Oh, I'm excited for it. So.
I'm also excited for another Paper Dolls.
Oh, yeah.
Original. I'm not sure what the difference is, though. What's the difference? Know. I've still got
Is it just a new list or is it a whole new game?
It looks like the same list.
Hmm.
I'm confused. I need to play the other Paper Dolls, but I'm confused by it.
Unless it's a region stack that's coming out, like a lot of Asia.
But it had a region stack. It was out in the NA and the AS. The NA and the AS.
The NA and AS. It is bananas.
It's crazy.
That was good. That was good.
Trophy list is mental. But yeah, so I don't know what's that shenanigans.
Maybe that song should be our intro this week.
What? Just Velvet singing
bananas. B-A-N-A-N-A-S.
Yeah, there you go.
Bananas. So
there you go. You've done it.
B-A-N-A-N-A-S.
I will so edit that and use that. Don't even play.
You don't even know what you've done there, do you? That's just going to be the intro for the rest of the podcast.
Oh, my God.
I don't know what else is coming out. You've got Sinking City, which I'm looking forward to. Paper Dolls. You've got another Necropara, volume 3. Necropara. You know, that game that takes 15 minutes.
Oh, Necropara.
That's what I said.
No, no, it's not.
Necropara.
Rah, 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 rah. Sound like a dog chewing food. Rah, 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 rah.
Kid Trip's coming out.
Yes, yes, that's the one I'm really.
That's the one you're what?
That's the one I'm really excited about.
Kid Trip. Yeah, you cut out. I was like, did we lose her?
Sorry, yeah.
Kid Trip. Like, Kid That's what I heard. Kid She got so excited. She went completely silent for that game.
Yeah, it looks so cute.
It reminds me of childhood.
It does. Yeah, and then he's trying to port the sequel, which is called, like, oh, what's the sequel called? Something in Hudge with a, he's got a little dog in the sequel. Oh, it must happen.
Yeah, but he said it's going to happen. He's just working on the bits and bobs, isn't he?
Yeah, he said that he's working on getting it ported over now, I think, so.
He said he's double busy.
Soon!
It's happening.
Everything's soon.
Everything's soon. I mean, there's so many games coming. It's crazy.
Yeah, it's going to be a heavy summer. Like, there's definitely a lot of games.
I remember when, like, summers were dead. Like, you wouldn't have... You wouldn't have anything to play, anything new from like the end of May until September, October when all the new games would drop. But now it's like every week, boom, boom, boom.
Yeah. All those indies are just coming out like hotcakes. And I love it. Love it.
Yeah, I'm loving it as well. There's a lot of VR coming as well.
Yeah, lots of VR. It kind of makes me want to get a headset, but I'm just like, no.
No, not happening. Well, to be fair, like the Lunar game, that's optional, isn't it?
There's a lot of options.
But I still do think that that should have a banner across it. VR optional. So people know. Over there, you know.
Yeah, it's a little confusing.
I do think that the store, see, the store does it on some, not on others. Like, get your stuff together. Come on now. Yeah.
Like, it will sell more if people know that it's not required.
Yeah, but it will also sell more if people know that you can. It's like it's a tale of two halves, that.
Yeah,
this is true.
Get your shit together. PR.
Yeah, so the sequel is Miles and Kilo. That's the sequel. It's by Four Horses Games, which is there in the UK with Fluffy.
That's right. Representing.
Yeah, but it's cute, like. If you take out the gameplay of the sequel, not on PS4 yet, the like dog is like doing all the work and the little boy is just like hanging onto his leash, and so he's just hanging on for the ride, and it just looks so cute. It makes me want to cry.
Oh dear. What was that? Anything with a dog in should play it. Anything.
Pretty much. As long as it doesn't die, like. What was the game where they shot the dog right in the beginning and I just turned it off?
Oh, Wolfenstein.
Fuck that game. Who puts that in a game?
Well, in Call of Duty, you shoot dogs. So, I mean,
no.
That's different. They're trying to attack you. This one, he just shoots a chained up dog. And I don't care about spoilers. If you don't know that, that's what happens. Don't play it.
You ruined that game for me now. How dare you?
You can't get through the first 5 minutes without it. So, like, you're dabbled in it. It's not so much a spoiler. It's like this is the intro, basically.
We're going to make you pull a dog. My gaming experience. So,
cry me a river.
I remember the second time I played through the beginning, I was just like, you know what? I'm just not going to shoot the dog. Like, you can't make me shoot the dog. And then you learn that you have to shoot the dog. And it's like,
you don't,
right.
It can make you.
Like, just, yeah. Man.
Then yeah. You learn that video games can make you do stuff.
I don't just have to continue on with it. Like, just,
yeah. We can turn the game off.
You could, but you didn't, did you?
Well, no, I did play a little bit after, but not a lot.
I think if I remember correctly, if you aim to the side and don't shoot the dog and like purposely miss, the guy in the room with you just does it.
Makes you. I think he holds your hand over the gun and makes you shoot.
Yeah, like you don't have a choice. It's like, I don't want to. And the game is literally like, well, too bad. This is happening. So,
that whole scene should come with like a trigger.
It kind of should. Yeah. Like, the sound that the dog makes is like the most heartbreaking in the world. Like,
so horrible.
Yeah. Like, you don't have to look at the screen and you'll be fine, but the sound is the one thing that I'm just like, all right.
Yeah,
well,
I don't like those, like in TV, like if you're watching a TV show and like, you know, the dog is, it was just the sound.
You know, they have there's a website that's like, does the dog die? And
oh,
so
really?
if there's an animal in a show, like whether or not that's a possibility, you can look it up, and it'll tell you. It basically will tell you whether or not the dog dies in it.
I prefer the can you pet the dog?
Yeah. Yeah, it's actually doesthedogdie.com.
Oh. Who did that?
Yeah, crowdsourced emotional spoilers for movies, TVs, books, and more.
Who was sitting at home and went, I know what I'm going to do.
I'm glad I'm gonna make a database because I have looked it up. I'm like, no, I'm about to find out, because the dog dies, I'm not watching it. So I can't rag on it too much. I've used it.
Oh man, oh dear. Well, moving on from dogs dying, because that's a real treat on the ears. Is there anything else you're looking forward to, ladies?
I'm looking forward to a beer later.
Well, duh.
It counts.
Yeah, but that's just known to us.
It is known.
No, I mean, other than like the games that we discussed coming out this week, I'm not real like hyped about any big game.
Not hyped about anything. You got nothing you're looking for.
No, not really.
Marvelous. What about you, Velvet?
No, I'm trying to think. I'm just like, all the stuff that I'm waiting for is like next week and the week after. So I'm just like, oh yeah, nope.
Soon.
Soon.
Yeah. Well, I don't play a lot of AAA games, so I can't even tell you like what's coming out on that front, to be honest.
Well, we all know that Cyberpunk's coming out.
Oh, well, yeah.
Keanu Reeves. So.
Well, that's 2020, so that's next year. 2020.
We've all got that deliciousness to wait for.
Oh, God.
What?
Bleh.
You shut your mouth. Even you would enjoy it. I don't know what you're jibbing.
You know what? I have a question for Velvet about her channel. I want to know what your aspirations are for like the whole thing. Like, what's your big goal, or what is your drive?
World domination.
World domination. Yeah.
I would like to get to a point where I've kind of talked about this a few times with some people, and they're just like, "Do you want to make a living off of it? Do you want to quit your day job?" And I'm just like, I don't know if I want to quit my day job, because I think I'd get bored, but I'd like to not work full time and be able to play more games, videos, stuff. It's just, it's not an easy thing to do by any standard. So I don't know. I'm still new to like the videos, whatnot. Mm-hmm. And it's really hard, like putting yourself out there. And it's just like, oh man, this looks shitload to get used to.
It's kind of constant, right? Like, in order to be successful, yeah. It's more the consistency than anything else. You have to be like on all the time.
Yeah, like I have to make like Fluffy and I know about Keymailer, but you have to do a minimum of 3 games a month, and even that is kind of like 3 doesn't sound like a lot. And then you're just like, okay, it's not just writing a guide. Like, I actually have to like make videos and stuff to get that minimum. And there's games that came out last year and the year before that I still want to work on. I still want to get guides, but unfortunately the newer games take a lot of priority to get done first. And I'm just like, well, but those games.
But I want to do those too.
Yeah, I do.
Making videos is hard. Like, I've only made 2, and I always end up messing them up or something. And then I have to do it, and like, I jib nonsense, absolute nonsense in mine. Like, because I'm just not used to doing it. And I think like one of the videos, I was like, oh, this looks like True Detective, like, I'm like, why am I talking about murder shit? I guess it fit right in, but yeah. And then like, you mess up when you die or something like that, but I just went fuck it and left it all in.
Yeah, but say that stuff I don't mind. I don't want to put out like a perfect run of a video, because somebody watching it is probably not going to have a perfect run themselves. Nah, and I think it makes people feel a little better, like, oh well, I died too, and I just
kept it in like whatever, like this is what happens when you die. So
yeah, I mean, I kind of like that it's real. And even like in your sun guide, there's a couple of spots where you like went in a different direction, but then you like laughed. And it was great because it just shows like the imperfection. I don't know. I like that.
Yeah. Like I know what part you're talking about. Like I turned around, it's just black, and I was like, where's the light? Oh my god, I don't know where I'm going.
Yeah, but instead of like, you didn't like get upset or anything, you just start laughing, which is great.
Because it's just, yeah, it's just silly. But even in I know you don't like the game, but back in 1995 there was a part where I went to hit one of the worm things, and I was just like, oh, go and hit this guy, and then he hit me first, and I just like stopped, and I was like, really? Like, can you just back off, please? But I like editing the videos more than I like them, which is weird.
But yeah, I mean, I think it's, I find it a bit weird editing the videos, because it took me a little bit to figure out how to do it, because I'm just rubbish at all that kind of stuff. It's not really my forte, is the editing and stuff. So yeah. I was like, oh god, I ended up cutting like oh, I ended up cutting the video. It was really weird. But yeah, it's like a chair in view. Like I was playing that. When I did it on my run, I hit the crocodile like the first time. When I went to do it on the video run, it was like three times or something. I was like, yeah. This, I'm just leaving it in. I can't be bothered. I'm not even going to bother. Just leave it in. It's really stupid. Like the things like you mess up, I think, when you're doing it. Do you find that with yours? Like when you're doing it, you just mess up bits.
Well, yeah. Like, for example, on still Ovivo, that new one, there is no, like, you can't replay a level and recollect everything in it. Like, you have to start over, and there is no chapter select or anything. So, to practice it, you have to upload your save file to the cloud, practice a level once you get it right, re-download your save and start it over. And when you get it, like, practice and like, okay, I'm good, and then you get to a part and you're just like, I fucking hate this shit. Yeah. I don't want to do this no more. I messed this up so bad. So you have to keep doing it over and over and over again, and I don't mind it too much. The walkover video or the voiceover videos, I feel really stupid making, because I'm just talking to myself in my apartment.
Yeah. Is that what you're doing now? Are you doing the talkovers after or during the playthrough?
No, I do them during. So Vulture and I were kind of talking about that, because he does his after, and I tried it, but it's a lot easier for me to explain things as I'm doing them versus like, oh, I hope I left myself enough time recording this video to make sure I explain what I need to explain.
I've only made like two video guides, but like I was like, I don't understand why you, I mean, obviously it's his way of doing it, and to him that's great. I don't understand that process, because like I think it's easier to do when you're doing it, because you're actually in it, for me anyway. I think it's happening, and you can like, I don't know, have a bit more fun with it. But obviously it's his way of doing it, and he's got a lot of videos out, so his process works for him, and that's great. But
yeah, he's definitely hammering him out. Like, he gets a lot of content in a short period of time. So.
Yeah. So it works for him. I just think, for me, I've only made a couple, so it's very different. And obviously I'm not very good with putting the stuff together, because I haven't done it enough, so I don't know, even know how I'd put the vocals on top of the video.
Yeah.
Probably mess that up completely. But yeah, I think it's like you say, like with the voice, doing it while you're going along.
Yeah, it's a lot easier to do it during.
Yeah. Do you use a capture card, or are you doing it in there?
No. I do have an Elgato. I had it from when I used to make PS3 guides, but I don't hook it up to the PS4. I know people prefer to see the actual trophy notifications pop, and that's mainly what it's for, so that those show up. But no, I just record them through the capture gallery.
Cool. Well, that sounds simple enough. Yeah.
I think that's how SD does it too. She just uses a share factory.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think she does. I have an Elgato, but it is a real pain to set up. It's like you might pull your own hair out.
Yeah, but once it's set up, it's really easy to use. But when it like it goes wrong and you have to reconnect everything, it's just like, oh my god, please stop doing this. Like, it's supposed to be making my life easier.
Yeah, it's like you want to throw your own TV out. It's crazy. But when I was doing it for the VR, it was like you just want to have it all. And like, I phoned them up, and they were like, "Yeah, you send us this, send us this." And I was like, in the end, I unplugged and replugged in. It worked fine. It's like an old IT trick. Have you turned it off and turned it back on again?
Yeah.
I IT desked myself, and I managed to fix it. So I was like, "Geez, I don't know why I bothered ringing you guys. Fixed it myself." But yeah, they are a real pain. So you need to like untick settings on the PS4 and
It's annoying. Well, I haven't tried it on the PS4. I've only used it on the PS3. But...
It's the same sort of nightmare process.
Yeah. I
imagine. I used to have one in the beginning of the PS3 days when I would do some videos. I don't remember which one I had. I ended up selling it, but that was a long time ago.
No, I think once you get it set up, it's like really good, but it is getting it set up, and it sometimes loses connection. It doesn't want to find its signal. It's like, oh, just work.
Yeah,
the amount of money it costs is really temperamental.
Sony really just needs to allow the trophy pops in the videos.
They do.
That's really the only reason anyone uses the capture card now.
But also make it so you can record longer than 60 minutes. I think it's only 60 minutes.
True.
Yeah, I don't understand why they don't allow the trophy notification. Like, you can turn them off. I would imagine if they add, like, just turn them off if you don't want them in the videos. But a lot of us do want them.
We want them. We want to see those notifications.
Damn it.
Give us features. God, what's wrong with you? You're trying to have numbers in our PSN again. Now this. God.
Well, it's like instead, like, if you're streaming, that, like, blurry message pops up in the left-hand corner. And it's like, that could be so much prettier. Like, that could not take up a quarter of my screen to show that I got a notification. Like, just... show the notification. Easy.
Yeah, good. It could give you options like little streaming box come up. Do you want to turn off your notifications while you're streaming?
Yeah.
Yes. Would you like to show trophy icons while you're streaming? Yes. Are Sony improving their system? No.
No.
What could we do? Everything better. Thanks. Bye. But yeah, I mean, maybe with the PS5, whenever that's coming, who knows, it will be easier. You would think that they would involve streaming, because a lot of people are streaming with the Twitch things, YouTube things, whatever it is. I don't. So
and even now, Mixer is coming up.
I should try streaming. There'd probably just be a lot of cussing.
You streaming? Yeah. Do they have an over 18?
They might be. One. All I do is cuss when I play video games. It's bad.
We know. I think there'd be a lot of complaints, but you could give it a go.
I don't think there'll be that many complaints. Just put like a warning. Just
I'd complain.
Pop your children.
Foul-mouthed woman gamer.
I'd complain. Risk. I'd put in a complaint straight up.
You better shut up.
I'd be like, dear YouTube, how dare you allow such content?
Oh my god.
So I think we've discussed everything.
I'm sick of talking to y'all.
You're sick of talking to us. Us? We're sick of talking to you. You dragged us in here. We didn't want to come. We're so good, bad. Me and Velvet had a little discussion before we came. I guess we'll stick around. I mean, God. If it'll keep it quiet for 10 minutes.
7 a.m. Who's up at 7 a.m?
Whose idea was it to record this?
I love how I'm like, I can do it at 5.
Yeah. I was like, no,
no. I'm like, no. Like, you're the only one in the U.S.
Yeah. 5 a.m. crazy woman.
I was like, I'm like, whenever. You're all like on weird times. It's tough. Are you doing any impressions before we go? Because, you know.
I don't think I have any. I mean, we could do a California impression. Like, if Velvet, like, totally talked like this. Like, oh, my God.
Oh, my God. I did this guide the other day, and you will never believe what I had to do for it. Like,
oh. Oh, my God, girl. What did you have to do?
Like, totally. Oh, my God.
It was bugged, and it would not pop. And I was like, oh. Anyways.
It's like, totally. Oh, my God.
God, I'm so glad I don't talk like that.
Yeah, that's the only person I have this week, Fluff. That's all I have.
So you're not going to do British this week?
No, I'm not going to do British this week.
No, you definitely aren't going to do British this week.
Would you like some tea and crumpet?
I was waiting for it.
I was waiting for the tea. I was waiting for the crumpets.
Would you like some tin crumpets?
No, I'm all right, Guff.
Governor. Yeah.
Hello, Governor.
Oh, poor Velvet got roped into this chaos.
Oh, it's fine.
She loves it. She loves the accent week.
I do.
Well, maybe we should just get people to send in ask to do random accents. That could be a little... I'm asking tough to do random accents. I don't want to really be any part of it.
Controversial.
I was about to say, it could start off as fun, and then I can see somebody getting like super offended by it. Just like, that's not what we sound like. And it's like, you do, but, though.
It's not what British people sound like, but she still does it. And I'm not offended.
Well, to be fair, like, just how the U.S. has a bunch of different accents here, whether you're East Coast, Southern, West Coast, England is the same. Like, your Northern accent is different to the Southern accent and just the posh accent.
Tough's accent don't fit into any of those categories. Anywhere across the UK. Not any of them work.
I speak the Queen's British.
The Queen's British.
Oh, God. Oh, it hurts.
I can't really. I speak the Queen's. Is that what you think they'd say? I speak the Queen's British, Governor. Let me in.
Yeah.
That's me putting on a fake accent from one I don't even know where.
Oh my God.
Jeez. Oh, I've got tea. Let me in to see the Queen. That's what she sounds.
I've brought from.
I think my accents all come from Wallace and Gromit. Those are where my accents.
Spot of croquet on the lawn.
I'm going to have spotted dick with the Queen.
You'd be tackled at the gates, you would. I've brought spotted dick, let me in. Tackle her!
What happened to Tough?
Well, it's a funny story. The Queen spotted dick. She offered the Queen some dick and it went downhill.
Went downhill from there.
Went downhill fast.
Oh.
We got pictures. It's on the news.
Well, we thank you, Velvet, for coming on the show and dealing with our shenanigans.
Oh, it was fun. Thank you for having me.
Yeah, we've got to take Tough back now. Find her out with me this week.
My ankle bracelet's beeping.
Oh, they upgraded you this week. My ankle bracelet last week, it was just papers. Not sure what you've been up to in there, but... Obviously, you're more high-tech security. Next time, it'll be some couple of guards with you.
There might be.
You'll enjoy that, though. So, you know, not sure that'd be a punishment.
Yes.
But, yeah, so thank you, Velvet, for coming on. Appreciated. Hope you enjoyed it. I didn't, but I enjoyed your company.
Yes, you did.
I enjoyed your company. Phenomena. I mean, they're just going to listen to that if they do and go, oh my God, what has happened? So thank you for listening and joining us. If you want to check us out, not check us out, but check us out, you can find us on at PS3 Imports. If you want to find me, you can't. If you want to find Tuff, you're more than welcome to. And you can find Velvet on 8 Bits of Velvet. So, yeah, thanks. And we'll see you in, I don't know, maybe a week, 2 weeks. Who knows? We're elusive.
Maybe, baby.
And we should all do a little theme tune as an exit. What do you reckon?
What are we doing? Oh, we're singing. Go ahead, Velvet.
Yeah, Velvet, you start us off. The Phenomena.
Oh, Phenomena.
Tambourine.
Oh, horrible.
That was rubbish. You're all fired. Laters.
Ciao.